Science, let's get into that today. We're gonna blind test 3 headphones that cost $1,500 per set of headphones. So, which one sound the best? Not get influenced by the brand. I'm gonna do it blindfolded, so let's get into it. So, at the testing table, guys, we got a Vioelectric preamp. I've listened to it already and it sounds incredible. If you compare this with a normal music producer audio interface and you're using a preamp from this kind of class, bruh, a whole world opens for you. It sounds completely different. Headphone wise, we got the Hifiman Aira headphone. It's really underdog if you ask me. It doesn't have the looks, but that's personally, but it sounds incredible. We got the Focal Clear MG Professional headphone, France brand. Then we got a brand from Berlin, Head Audio, which looks insane, you know, like it's like so big, it's incredible. And I'm not sure if this test is really gonna work out, to be honest, but I'm gonna use these two things. I'm gonna put them on my head. And the reason behind is that I don't want to be influenced by the association I already have with a specific headphone. So I really want to adjust the audio quality of these headphones on a few things. The low end, mid range, high frequencies, and just the overall spectrum on how it's translating. This all is obviously subjective, so it's personal base. Like, you might find another headphone sounding the best one of these three. I'm gonna try it in this video blindfolded, so I cannot either feel the headphones as well, and I'm gonna see which headphones sound the best in my opinion. So I'm not sure how we're really gonna do this. I'm just gonna put this on. I got a song, by the way, from Michael Jackson ready here, Thriller. I got a space bar here so I can push play. Tommy, the cameraman behind the camera, is gonna put the headphone on my head once he's ready. I'm gonna put this on. So I've explained to you, Tommy, you just put in a random jack cable, put the headphone on my head, and then we're gonna see how it's gonna work out though. So this is gonna look really stupid, I think. Of course, this also has impact on the audio quality. And then I have this thing, which I'm gonna cover my eyes in. It's ridiculous, you know, like, look at me, bro. I don't even know what I have. So let me see. I think I'm ready for the first one. So this is fixed. I got space bar here. Let me see. Yeah, so I'm just gonna let this happen, guys. I'm just gonna let it happen, let my ears decide what's best for me, you know, which gives me the best experience, which don't. Okay, am I ready?
Yes.
Okay, sounds interesting. You can take it off if you want to, Tommy. Put it down, I won't look, so I don't know which one it is. Yes. Woo! That was intense, guys, that was intense. So that was the first headphone. Audio wise, it sounded incredible. I think all three of these headphones sounds very incredible. Low frequencies, I think it's a bit too much. This is really critical thinking, obviously. I think low end, it could have been cleared out more in a flat spectrum, to be honest. But overall, you could hear a lot of detail. I was waiting for the vocal part in Michael Jackson's Thriller song. Mid, it was very filled, but if you look at mid-low frequency range, it was a bit too much, since I'm really looking for a natural responding headphone, which it was definitely. High frequencies, super clear, super crisp. Overall spectrum, I think that was the most incredible thing. It just sounded really 360, like you were at the concert, like at a concert itself, you know, listening to the song. So I think overall, I mean, it's an incredible headphone, incredible, but maybe a bit too much low, but we're gonna see that with the second headphone, which we're gonna test now.
Yes.
This is funny though, because the other one was heavy, but this one is almost as heavy as I cannot really tell the difference now, so I'm confused already which headphone it was. Okay, I'm good. Keep my eyes closed for a second. Can you pull out the cable?
Mix it up.
Yes. Whoa! So the second headphone, and to be honest, at the beginning I thought like I'm really gonna feel which headphone it is, but the second headphone felt also super heavy. The first one felt heavy on my head, so I didn't really know. But this one was, in my opinion, at that moment, maybe it was just how I had it on my head, but it was really balanced out through the whole frequency spectrum. It was cleaner in the lows, less overpowered in the lows. It was just balanced really well, and as well, since there are open headphones, really spacey sound, so you could hear a cowbell right up front on the side, you could hear the vocal coming in from the left. It was a really interesting sound, which I really could enjoy for hours if you're listening to such a headphone. Which one it was, I'm gonna see later. Without further ado, let's check out number 3. That was number 3. Boy, man, again, all three of these headphones sound incredible. This last one, I think overall it was the best sounding. It really had a balanced low. It just matched it all up. The part where in Michael Jackson Thriller the vocals came in, it just had an ambient sound in the vocals that they really try to go after while recording something like this. It was really, if you were there at the recording and even in full effect with all the details included, it was just overall super well sounding. Low, highs, mids, the whole thing could match. Maybe if I think back on the cowbell, there was something right with the other headphone right on top. It was more in a circle in this recording, but still then there was a really good overall spectrum of the audio, especially super clean, balanced out. It's gonna be a super hard guess between the second and the third one which one sounds best. The first one had a little bit too much bass, but maybe that's also how I approached it at that moment and how it was put on my head. I don't know, but overall all three headphones sound incredible. So Tommy, can you point out the first headphone that I had on? Was it this one?
No.
Was it this one?
Yes.
Alright, so the vocal head actually was then the first one. Like, I listened to it before and at that moment it didn't have a over-present bass response, to be honest. But I actually thought back in, to be honest, I thought like the head maybe has a bit much too low end. So the second one, was it the Aira?
No.
Was it the head then? Must be, yes. Okay, second one was the head. Boo. Incredible. That I really didn't know, to be honest. Like, the second one, really, really good option. Of course, a headphone like this, you know, see how big it is, you know. Not sure if it's comfortable in the long run, but it definitely sounded really, really good. And the third one must then be this bad boy, and I think this is one of the most underrated ones. I mean, if you think about those two headphones and this one, maybe in hi-fi world it's super well known, in music producer world I didn't know it yet, but it's definitely a really good headphone. Translating incredible, comfort wise it's next level. You know, it just feels like a feather on your head. Really clean translating spectrum. These are all three open headphones, as you can see, open back headphones. And yeah, I think it's not cheap. It's 4,500 euros on headphones here on the table, with a preamp that's approximately 3,500-4,000 euros. So this whole loop is definitely expensive, really expensive. But of course, this is not real science, not a real validated test, but it's just set up to give my opinion based on the audio quality and not the association I have with a specific brand or the comfort, just pure audio quality testing. I hope this helped. If it did, please like the video, subscribe to the Inside Audio YouTube channel, and remember, always keep making music. Until next time.